Hallo und herzlich willkommen zu Thema 8. Namen buchstabieren. Spelling names. In this topic, you will learn to ask someone to spell their name in German. You understand the spelling of names and spell your own and other people's names. In this video, I'll first give you an overview of some key words and phrases and some important grammar points. Try to understand the words and phrases from context and stop the video to read and repeat after me. After you've watched the video, there will be plenty of practice opportunities on the learning platform. Viel Spaß! In the last video, we looked at how to fill in a form at a hotel. Let's look at some more typical interactions at a hotel. So let's go back to Hotel Drei Kronen. Look at this image and read the questions. Wer ist das? Wo ist die Person? Was macht die Person? Before you continue, take a minute to try and guess who this person could be and what she could be doing. Let's read the short text first. Das ist Jenny Baker. Sie arbeitet im Hotel Drei Kronen an der Rezeption. Jenny telefoniert mit einem Gast. You should either know all the words, or if not, you should be able to guess them from context. If you need more time, stop the video now and read again. Jenny telefoniert mit einem Gast. She talks to a guest on the phone. Let's look at what Janet says on the phone. Wie ist Ihr Name bitte? Wie ist Ihr Name bitte? And here's what the guest replies. Andreas Schmidt. Jenny doesn't understand, maybe because the connection is poor or because maybe the guest didn't say his name clearly, so Jenny asks him to repeat. Entschuldigung, wie bitte? You can use this phrase whenever you do not understand. It's very handy. Entschuldigung, wie bitte? Try it yourself. Entschuldigung, wie bitte? Entschuldigung means excuse me, sorry, apologies. Wie bitte means pardon. The guest then answers by repeating his name. Mein Nachname ist Schmidt. Mein Vorname ist Andreas. You already know this from the last lesson, right? Nachname, surname. Vorname, first name. But Jenny is still not sure, so she asked the guest to spell his name for her. Wie schreibt man das bitte? Wie schreibt man das bitte? You know part of this already. Schreibt, schreiben. In the last lesson, we had unterschreiben, to sign a document. Schreiben on its own means to write. Here, Jenny is asking, wie schreibt man das bitte? Which means, how does one write this? Literally, of course you wouldn't say it like this. It means, how do you spell this? How do you spell that? So the guest answers, ich buchstabiere, and then he spells his name. S-C-H-M-I-D-T und A-N-D-R-E-A-S. Okay, let's look at these phrases a bit more closely. So you already know how to ask someone for their name, but let's recap. Wie ist dein Name? Wie heißt du? Wie ist Ihr Name? Wie heißen Sie? Do you remember which of these phrases are formal and which are informal? That's right. Dein and du are informal. Wie ist dein Name? Wie heißt du? You would say that in informal situations. And ihr und sie are formal. Wie ist Ihr Name? Wie heißen Sie? You would use this in more formal situations. Note that dein is the possessive article of du, dein, du, you can sort of see the connection there, right? So that's you and your, yeah, informally. So ihr und sie are also connected. Wie ist ihr Name? That's how, what is your name? Und wie heißen sie? What, how are you called? Yeah, so it's again your and you. They're connected. You don't see the connection there. So clearly, apart from the capital letters, right? And remember, capital letters for ihr and sie mean it's formal. It's the formal you. So these three phrases are new. How do you ask someone to repeat something? We've got several options here. Entschuldigung, wie bitte? Noch einmal bitte. Langsamer bitte. Let's try again and repeat after me. Entschuldigung, wie bitte? Noch einmal bitte. Langsamer bitte. Now, with all three phrases, you can get someone to repeat something for you. Yeah? But what do these phrases mean literally? Have a look at these and try to guess. So, Entschuldigung, wie bitte? We already talked about this, right? Entschuldigung, excuse me, sorry, apologies. Yeah? Wie bitte literally means how, please. Of course, that doesn't make any sense in English. So it's, excuse me, what was that? Or how, yeah, I don't know. Yeah? So, what, please? Yeah, or pardon. In English, you would say pardon, probably. Noch einmal bitte. Literally, once again, please. And langsamer bitte. More slowly, please. Again, you can use all three phrases if you want someone to repeat something for you. If you want someone to spell something for you, these are the phrases you can use. Wie schreibt man das? Wie schreibt man das? Literally, how does one write this? How do you spell this? Buchstabieren Sie das bitte? Buchstabieren Sie das bitte? Spell that, please. Buchstabierst du das bitte? Buchstabierst du das bitte? Spell that, please, but informally. Yeah, again, buchstabieren Sie das bitte, formal. Buchstabierst du das bitte, informal. Let's look at other situations where you might need someone to spell something for you. Again, let's look at the picture. What do you see? Who are these people? Wer sind die Personen? Was machen die Personen? Have a guess. Okay, let's read this short text. Das sind Philipp und Julia. Sie sind auch im Hotel Drei Kronen. Sie sind in einer Reisegruppe und heute Abend gehen sie in ein Restaurant. Philipp schreibt Julias Kontaktinformation in sein Telefon. Stop the video now if you need more time to read the text. I'm sure you can guess most of, if not all of the new words in this short text from context, but let's have a quick quiz. So, what is the German word for travel group? That's right, Reisegruppe. Yeah, you already know Reise, travel, trip, journey from the last lesson. And Gruppe is very close to the German, to the English word group, isn't it? So, Philipp and Julia are planning to go to a restaurant together for dinner and they're exchanging numbers. Let's read the dialogue between the two. Wie ist dein Name, bitte? Ich heiße Julia Wagner. Noch einmal bitte? Julia Wagner. Buchstabierst du das bitte? Mein Familienname ist Wagner. W-A-G-N-E-R. Mein Vorname ist Julia. J-U-L-I-A. If you need more time to read the dialogue, stop the video now. There's one new word in this dialogue. Familienname, family name. Do you remember the other word that we've already learned for this in the previous lesson? Nachname, that's right. Nachname, Familienname, das sind Synonyme, the synonyms. You can use both interchangeably. Nachname, Familienname. Okay, let's see what else Philip and Julia are talking about. Next, Philip asks, und wie ist deine E-Mail-Adresse? julia.wagner@online.de. Und wie ist deine E-Mail-Adresse? Moment, ich buchstabiere PHIL-JEAN@telekom.fr. If you want to say an email address, you will usually need the following. Strich, Punkt, at. So to spell a name or an email address, you also need to know how to say the letters of the alphabet in German. Der Buchstabe, the letter. Das Alphabet, the alphabet. Okay, let's look at the German alphabet. I'll read the letters out loud. You try to repeat after me. The blue words in the square brackets, they're not actual words. They're just there to help you maybe remember better how the letters are pronounced, right? So keep that in mind. They're not real words. They're just a bit of a pointer as to how to pronounce these letters in German. Okay, let's get started. Maybe listen first for the first round and then rewind the video. And then listen again and repeat as well. A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, Z. Now, stop the video and try to say the German alphabet yourself out loud and then rewind and if you need to remember, if you need a reminder or if you want to check if you've got it right. You might have noticed that there are a couple of tricky letters, yeah, tricky words, especially if you're thinking English or if you're coming from English. Let's read the letter words in yellow again, because what they all have in common is that they sound pretty similar to an English letter word, or that they're really easy to mishear if you don't pay close attention. Okay, let's read the yellow ones. A, E, H, I, R oder R, V, W. Yeah. So from my experience, these are probably the trickiest ones to remember, or they're easy to mix up or to mishear. So pay special attention to getting those right. Okay, let's practice. Let's spell these four names. Wie schreibt man das? Buchstabieren Sie bitte. Hermine. So stop the video now if you want to have a go. Hermine. Ich buchstabiere H-E-R-M-I-N-E. Ali. Again, stop the video if you want to have a go. Ich buchstabiere A-L-I. Walter. Stop the video if you want to try yourself. Walter. Ich buchstabiere W-A-L-T-E-R. Und Vera. Stop the video if you want to try. V-E-R-A. Let's practice some more. Stop the video now to spell these two names and then start the video again to see if you've got it right. You already know these two names. Julia Wagner. Ich buchstabiere J-U-L-I-A W-A-G-N-E-R. Andreas Schmidt. A-N-D-R-E-A-S S-C-H M-I-D-T. German also has a couple of special characters. Sonderzeichen. Special characters. So these are characters that most other languages don't have. And these special characters are E, A-Umlaut, Ö, O-Umlaut, Ü, O-Umlaut. And in Germany and Austria, you also have this funny B-shaped letter, which is called SZ, or scharfes S. And that's exactly what it sounds like, a sharp S sound, scharfes S. In Switzerland, you simply use a double S to indicate the sound. And in this course, we're using the Swiss spelling approach, so you won't come across the SZ letter much. But you might see it in other German language resources, so simply try to remember that this funny shaped B letter is a very sharp S sound. Now, let's go back to the three letters with the dots on top. Yeah, the Umlaut. A-Umlaut, U-Umlaut, U-Umlaut. So A, O, U-Umlaut are the words you can use to describe these letters, but what they sound like is ä, ö, ü. Okay, let's try this. So the sound of the letter ä, a umlaut, is very close to the vowel in the English word hair, hair, yeah? Hair, ä, hair. The sound of the letter ö, umlaut, ö, umlaut, is very close to the vowel sound in the English word learn, learn, ö, learn. Yeah, it's learn but a bit tighter. Learn, ö, ö. Now the trickiest one is the ö umlaut, yeah, the U with the two dots, because there's really no equivalent in the English language. But the closest or the easiest to get to it is to produce a very high pitched e. E, and then purse your lips. E, that's what it is. E, you can try that. E, ü, ü, ü. That's the U umlaut. Okay, probably your own names won't have an umlaut, but it never hurts to try and practice a little bit. So, how do you spell these names? Wie schreibt man die Namen? Thies Köster. Thies Köster. Stop the video now if you want to have a go. Thies Köster. Ich buchstabiere T-H-I-E-S-Z. K-Ö-S-T-E-R. Bärbel Müller. Bärbel Müller. Again, stop if you want to try. R B E L M U L L E R. Whew. Okay, so for the letters with the dots, as I said, you can always also try and say A umlaut, U umlaut, O umlaut, if that's easier. Okay, well done. So now it's your turn. I'll ask you questions and you reply. Wie heißen Sie? Entschuldigung, Wie bitte? Entschuldigung, wie schreibt man das? Buchstabieren Sie bitte. Well done. There was not a lot of grammar in this lesson, but let's look at two new verbs we encountered. The verb schreiben is only semi-new to you because you already know unterschreiben, to sign something, to send a document. If a verb gets a prefix, so a little small word in front of it, it changes the meaning, but it doesn't usually change what happens to the ending, so to the grammar side of things. These verbs tend to work the same way as the ones with different prefixes, yeah, or without one. So here we've got ich schreibe, du schreibst, sie oder man schreibt, wir schreiben, ihr schreibt, sie schreiben. A small thing that's new here is the man. We came across this in wie schreibt man das? How does one write this? Yeah, so this doesn't have anything to do with man. Yeah, so the man in German here with non-capitalized and just one N is the general one. How does one write this? How do you spell that? How does one spell that? Yeah, that's the man. And it's in the same category as and sie. Yeah, it gets the same ending for the verbs. Wie schreibt man das? So the other new verbs are buchstabieren und telefonieren. Yeah. And all verbs ending in ieren, yeah, ihren, they all work the same way. Yeah. Ich buchstabiere, du buchstabierst, sie oder man buchstabiert, wir buchstabieren, ihr buchstabiert, sie buchstabieren. Ich telefoniere, du telefonierst, sie, man telefoniert. Wir telefonieren, ihr telefoniert, sie telefonieren. Gut gemacht. So, well done. That's it for topic 8. If you want, watch the video again or continue with the lesson on the learning platform for some practice activities and then come back to this video later for revision and pronunciation practice.